Good morning and welcome to Prakash Vidyalaya, where students love to learn. My dear students of class 6, today we are going to do the third chapter of geography, that is motions of the earth. I hope all of you are with your textbooks. Please follow the lines. There are two movements of the earth. One is the rotation, the other is the revolution of the earth. Rotation is the movement of the earth on its own axis. Rotation of the earth is the movement of the earth on its own axis, which causes day and night. And revolution is the movement of the earth when the earth revolves round the sun and it has a path or orbit on which it moves. This is called the orbital plane, and it takes 365 days to move round the sun. And the sun lights the half of the earth which is facing towards it. The sphere of the earth which faces the sun has the day, and the sphere of the earth which faces opposite to the sun has night. And this marking line which divides the day and night is called the circle of illumination. What would happen if the earth had not rotated? Can anyone answer? Had the earth not rotated, then the portion of the earth facing the sun would always be day, and the portion of the earth facing the opposite side will always have night. And there will be continuous heat or temperature in that hemisphere which faces the sun, and there will be complete darkness and night in that hemisphere which is opposite to the sun, with lowest temperature. The second motion of the earth, revolution around the sun in its orbit, is called revolution. It takes 365 and 1/4 day to complete one revolution around the earth. That is 1 year. For 1 year to revolve around the sun. We consider a year as consisting of 365 days and ignore the 1/4 or the 6 hours for the sake of convenience. And this 1/4 day or the 6 hours is added after 4 years in a year, and we call that a leap year. That means this 4 6 hours are made into one more day and added to a leap year, making it 366 days, and February having 29 days. I think you all know that February has 29 days in a leap year. The path in which the earth moves around the sun is called the elliptical orbit. This is not circular path, it's an elliptical path. That means the north and the south axis, north and south pole, the axis is tilted at 66 degrees. Now if you look at the figure, you will see that on 21st June, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. The rays of the sun falls directly on Tropic of Cancer. And the Tropic of Cancer, as a result, these areas receive more heat. The areas near the poles receive less heat. The poles get slanting rays of the sun, thereby having less heat. And the places beyond the Arctic Circle experiences continuous daylight for 6 months, and this same will not happen in the opposite hemisphere. Since large portion of northern hemisphere is getting light from the sun, it is summer in the regions of north of equator, and the longest and the shortest night at these places occur on 21st June. On 21st June, it is the longest day and the shortest night. Therefore, it is summer in the southern hemisphere, with longer days and shorter nights. The reverse happens, opposite of this happens in the northern hemisphere. This position of the earth is called winter solstice. Do you know that Christmas is celebrated in Australia in the summer season? It is because of this reason. On 21st March and 23rd September, direct sun rays fall on the equator, and neither of the poles are tilted towards the sun. So we have equal days and equal nights. This is called the equinox. Equinox means equal day and equal nights. That is on 21st March and 23rd September. 23rd September is autumn season in the northern hemisphere, while in the southern hemisphere it is spring. The opposite is the case on 21st March. Now on 23rd September, it is autumn season in the northern hemisphere and spring in the southern. On 21st March, it becomes opposite. It becomes spring in northern hemisphere and autumn in the southern hemisphere. Thus, you find that there are days and nights, the changes in seasons because of rotation and revolution of the earth. When earth revolves, you get changes in season, and when earth rotates, there is change in day and night. I hope you all understood. Thank you.